Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Hero to Superhero. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series Angular 0 to Hero in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series Hero to Superhero, I'm focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I'm going to explain why it is necessary to use trackBy along with ngFor. To explain that, I have created a very simple Angular application in which I am showing few names using ngFor. And I have a button to refresh the names. And if you see in app component ES, initially I have 5 users in users array. And inside refresh function, I'm changing those users. To be specific, I'm removing the user with ID 3 and changing the name of the user with ID 4 and adding a new user with ID 6. So if I click the button, we can see it is changed. This is working, but it has a performance impact. Let me show it. Let me inspect this first. Keep an eye on here. When I click the button, we can see all the divs are getting refreshed. Now this has already changed. If I click one more time, again it is refreshing the DOM and checking for changes even if there is no change. So if I click many times, it will keep on checking and reload the divs. This will impact the performance, especially when we have a big list of users. This is because change detection does not know what has actually changed. But we can fix that using trackBy. Let me add the trackBy and specify a function. Let me also create that function. This may accept a parameter index and let me simply return that index. Okay, now if I refresh, we can see only these 3 divs are getting refreshed. If I click again, it won't refresh because now Angular knows what are the things getting changed. Even here, we can see item with ID 5 is refreshed even though it is not changed. That is because when we pass index, all the items below that index will also refresh to check whether there is any change. So to optimize further, instead of using the index, we can use some unique value in the object. Let me use the ID. Now we can see the item with ID 5 is also not refreshed. Only the divs got affected is refreshed. This is how we can optimize using trackBy. So trackBy is very important when we use ngFor, especially with object arrays. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.